one of our tips for 2009, and trust me, ladies and gentlemen, they did not disappoint. Will you please welcome to the Maidavale Studios, LaRoux!
What's the name? You know that you, I know you better than this. I could be here when you call. I'll make you top by the list. And in the crush of the dark, I'll be all out in the mist. I can see you running with desire for a kiss. Psycho. Oh, they can sell it all they want, but you cannot agree. I don't like the taste of their morality. You'll find your bread and your butter where you fake it, and put your face in the gutter of a snake pit. Well, but our communication is telepathy. What you give is what you get out of us naturally. And we can wait till the shadow grows long, and turn the page of a story that has long since gone.
LaRoux came about a few years ago. I was at a New Year's Eve party playing guitar in some office in top of a club in Brixton. There was a guy called Jason Bacon in there. He just said, oh, you're into music then, you're a singer. And I was like, yeah, yeah. And he said, oh, I really like your voice. And I was like, great, great. He's like, I'm a producer. And I was like, all right, what's your name? I was like, please, I need help. And I've been looking just to meet someone like that, just who could help me and give me some connections for a while. And he said, you should meet my friend Ben. And that was it. It was that simple. Weird.
You can take it.
Live was never something I sort of would dream about or fantasize about, which is kind of strange, I guess. I just think writing songs is the coolest thing anyone can ever do. I just think, like, there's nothing sexier than writing a song. I don't know. Don't know about you, but that's how I feel. The way it works with me and Ben when we write is it's sort of a mixture of me bringing stuff to the table and working that out with him. Him sort of... He'll often have a really bold idea as well, which this is what Ben's really good at, is he'll say something really bold, like, let's write a song like Shout by Tears for Fears, and I'll be like, that's quite a challenge you're setting yourself. But he'll do stuff like that, which I won't. He's a lot more sort of brash, whereas I'll just be like, I've got some nice chords. Said, look, I don't really want to do this like guitar thing anymore. It's like really old hat, and I'm not there anymore in my life, in my head. I want something that makes me want to dance. I don't want to sit on a stool with a guitar. Like, I wouldn't go to that show, so why am I going to do it myself? And then we went away and just listened to like Blancmange and Japan and Heaven 17 and stuff like that for like a couple of years, and just made the record. And then we wrote Quicksand, and that was it, really.
Thank you.
It's a great privilege to be performing with them today. And yesterday we had such a fun rehearsal day. We really did. We had such a laugh. I think as well for Ben. I mean, I wasn't there in the 80s. I wish I had been, but I wasn't there. And he was, and I'm not, like, I think Heaven 17 are like real heroes to Ben. He probably wouldn't, you know, go too much into it. But they're real heroes for him, and he's really excited, yeah.
The rehearsals have been absolutely bang on, to be honest. It's been plain sailing. I mean, no tantrums, no fights.
Her phrasing and her melodies are really don't go where you think they go, and it's really interesting. So I'm really looking forward to singing with Ellie. We've yet to decide who sings what line and how we split the song up, but I'm sure we'll work it out. I'm sure it'll be really good.
I think it's great that Six Music are doing stuff like this, you know, this sort of collaborative thing, and seeing as well to show people, because I think a lot of people who might love our music and have our record still wouldn't know where it's come from or what it's been influenced by. They'll just go, it's electronic music. You go, well, no, actually, all these sounds and everything, it's just massive, you know, it's sort of taken, obviously, from other people. But although people hear you say that, maybe they don't know the bands you're talking about. Lots of people I know still don't know who Heaven 17 are, or certainly don't know who Japan or anything like that are. So I think it's great because it brings that music back to my generation. It can only be a good thing.
Without lust.
Thank you.
The temptation that we're going to do tonight, it's not one that's really ever been heard before, because we've gone back even further than the kind of radio album version. We've gone back to the demo that we first wrote in Sheffield, which we heard the other day at Abbey Road, and there's a little sequence of part that's in there that kind of disappears in the version that everybody knows that made it onto the album. So this is the version pre-orchestra that we're playing tonight, and it's never really been heard before. And we just thought it'd be apt to do a version like that with Ellie, and just kind of really quite stripped down and electronic.
It's just such a classic, massive dance and electronic and pop song. It's like covers three genres and equally successful in all of them. And it's just, and yet it's one of those songs everyone knows, but not everyone knows who it's by. They're like, yeah, no, you sing it to them and you go, Heaven 17, Temptation. They go, no, I don't know what you're talking about. You go, Temptation. They go, oh yeah, and I know, you know.
Thank you.
17 and Ellie Jackson. When was the first time, Ellie, you heard Heaven 17 and what attracted you to their music?
Temptation, probably. I didn't know it was by Heaven 17 when I was really young, obviously. You just know Temptation.
Yeah.
Which is the true mean, you know, true where you can tell a hit is when you go, I don't know who it's by, but I know it, yeah. But I think it was Ben, he said, your love is Penthouse and Pavement. And I was like, oh, I just love the artwork. I didn't even care what was on the record. I was like, this is amazing. And he played it to me, and I think Fascist Groove Thing was the first thing I ever heard. And I just thought, oh, great lyric. And I just listened to the record, and then I really got into how men are.
And so, boys, when did you first become aware of LaRue?
I think Ellie was probably on your show,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, our show, I think. Yeah.
And she'd played one of our tunes. It might have even been And That's No Lie, I think.
It would have been that or Come Live With Me.
Right, I think.
Which I also wanted to do with you because it would have been really pervy. I was 37. No, it starts with the lyric, I was 37, she was 17.
Oh, you should have said.
Make up your own mind.
That. Yeah, we could have done that. I really know.
Well, we can do it now if you want.
Oh, instead of mate.
No, but then, so I just went onto Ellie's MySpace site and said, hello, I hear that you like M17. Thanks very much for playing the tunes. And, you know, I really like your tunes too. She wrote me an email about going, oh, I love your tunes. And,
in a northern accent.
Yes, exactly.
How could you tell?
She's got a great northern accent, by the way.
I'm not doing it.
You just did it.
No, I didn't.
You did?
No, I didn't.
You're going to do one more song for us, and you better explain what it is and why.
Mm. I had an idea to do Sign Your Name by Terence Trent D'Arby. And then I thought, oh, yeah, Martin produced that, so that's a nice connection. But without knowing that Ellie at the same point had thought, it'd be nice to do Sign Your Name. And even you then later said that Cover My Eyes was...
Inspired by that
song as well, so there's a really nice connection to it. So we are going to do now Come Live With Me.
Look at panic on your face, it's great.
Oh, no, they're not. For the final time, exclusive to Six Music, live at the BBC's Maidavale Studios, Heaven 17 and LaRue!
want you to be my baby.